In this video, we're going to talk about seven topologies in the real numbers. The idea will be to establish some kind of order between them, that is, compare them. Which one is a subset of which one? Which ones are not even comparable? If you don't know these words that I'm using, then I suggest you check out our videos in the definitions of topologies. And also for this video, it's essential that you know the definition and you know how to work with bases of topologies. If you haven't done any exercises on bases, maybe don't worry too much because we will be working a lot with them here, so you will get a lot of practice. Being seven topologies, it's going to be a bit long. So on this video, I'm only going to define them, and in the videos to follow, we will continue with what I mentioned before. We're not going to finish studying these topologies here. We will see them all the time throughout the reproduction list. So it's essential for us to actually understand how they are built. Let's start. We will start with the standard topology of the real numbers. The standard topology, I'm going to write it just as T, and if I say the topological space R with the standard topology, I'm just going to say it R, the real numbers, no subindexes. The standard topology is generated by the standard bases. That is the following. It's the set of all the open intervals AB, where A is obviously smaller than B. So the bases are all the open intervals. That means that our topology is formed by arbitrary unions and finite intersections of open intervals. It's the most common topology and probably the one you have been studying when you studied analysis. So things will always be more natural for us when working on the standard topology, not so much on the others. The second topology is the lower limit topology. We will denote the topology by tau L. And when we say the real numbers with the lower limit topology, we will say RL. And it's the one generated by the bases of intervals for which the left extreme is closed. So A, B, opening B, where obviously A is smaller than B. So again, the basis is this one, and the topology will be formed by arbitrary unions of this type of intervals and finite intersections. The next one is the upper limit topology. It is denoted as tau sub U and RU, and it's obviously, you can probably imagine, it's generated by AB closed in the right extreme, where A is smaller than B. Then we have the K topology, denoted by tau sub K or R sub K, and it's the one generated by the union of two sets. First we have the open intervals, and also the open intervals minus K, where K is the set of all the numbers of the form 1 over n, with n a natural number. So we're taking all the open intervals, just like in the standard topology, but we are also generating it with unions and intersections of intervals except points of the form 1 over n. And this may seem like it doesn't change much, but believe me, it does, and we will see that in the following videos. Then we have the topology of rays. This one I will denote it by tau sub r, or the real numbers sub R, and I will just consider the left ray, the open ray will be, everything will be sort of the same, and it's the one generated by left rays, that is, intervals of the form minus infinity A, for A just any real number. And the next two topologies are two that we have actually worked with already, the finite complement topology, denoted by tau f or rf, and it's formed by all the sets u subsets of the real numbers such that R minus U is finite, or it's the real numbers. And finally, the countable complement topology. We worked with this in our previous videos, solving one of the exercises in Munker's book, with denoted by tau c and rc, and it's generated by the subsets of the real line such that r minus u is countable or the real numbers. So these are all the topologies we are going to work with in the videos that follow.